My talk is about the revival of fractals in this new world of color images. They never died, but they are kind of forgotten. So I'll present briefly the context, then I'll present the fractal analysis tools, our approach, then I'll insist on the validation of our approach, and then present some results and draw some conclusions. The context in this application of video quality assessment is the development of video quality metrics in the case of a reduced reference, when you have some information about the original transmitted video signal, which is, however, not available at the receiver. And I have to mention here the widely known quality metrics, like which are basically in two categories: the classical distance measures, and then the more developed ones, like structural similarity, which was already mentioned, and the video signal-to-noise ratio, developed by Chandler and Hemami, and the blockiness, well-known by, developed by Winkler. The issue with all these metrics is that they are only for gray-level images, and we are talking about color images, and they are not really invariant to translation, rotation, and scale, or crop, or mirror, which can occur in a chain of video signal processing. And the worst is the fact that they tackle different aspects of the degradation separately and independently. So I'm talking about contrast or blockiness or blur or new colors. They are treated separately. So we are looking for a method to have answers to all those questions. So ideally, the desired solution should be invariant to translation, rotation, and so on. And most important, should treat all the degradation aspects as a whole, as it is perceived by the user. So it is also important to have an objective metric which reflects the human vision system way of seeing the images. So we embraced these fractal analysis tools based on the assumption that degradation is something that occurs at different scales. So the blockiness effect may be at large and small scales. And in addition, the fractal measures have all the desired properties, but there is also an issue here. There are no color approaches for the fractal dimension and lacunarity computation, which are the two main fractal analysis tools. I'll remind briefly how the fractal dimension is computed. In fact, the box counting fractal dimension, which the fractal dimension is a measure of the complexity of a fractal object. So for a one-dimensional signal, you just cover your signal with boxes of size delta, and you count how many boxes it takes to cover your signal. Then you repeat this process for several sizes of boxes, so for several deltas. And in a log-log space, for a pure fractal, the n of delta should be, as a function of delta, should be a constant. So then you estimate the fractal dimension as the slope of the regression line through the points of log n of delta, log delta. Our approach is the following. We consider the image to be a five-dimensional object. to have two special coordinates, x and y, and three color coordinates, for example, RGB. And we extended the probabilistic approach of Richard Voss for estimating the fractal dimension. And instead of boxes, we use hyperboxes of dimension 5 to cover the color image. And the method will estimate the probability probability matrix P of M and delta, which is the probability that M pixels will fall inside of a box of size delta. Then N of delta is computed based on this probability matrix, and this allows you to estimate the fractal dimension. The same guy, Richard Voss, proposed a definition for the lacunarity based on the same probability matrix. There exist several other definitions, starting with the Mandelbrot original one, but that definition is just a number. We prefer this distribution function proposed by Voss, which allows us to compute the lacunarity for color images as well. And let's see some results in the context of video quality assessment. You can see an original video frame from the football standard test sequence and the corresponding degraded video frame, which was received at the destination. And you can see that the color fractal dimension for the original image was 3.14, and the color fractal dimension of the degraded one is 3.31. So there is an increase in the complexity of the image due to degradation. As for the lacunarity curves, you can see the red curve corresponding to the original image, and the blue curve, which is high above the red one, indicating a more lacunar image, again due to degradation. And the most delicate part was to validate or to prove that our method is valid. And we tackled this issue from three directions, independent and separate. First, we analyzed the 3D RGB histograms. So you can see here the 3D histogram for the original image and the 3D histogram for the degraded image. So you can see that the cloud of points is more spread for the degraded one, indicating that the content in colors was augmented due to the degradation. Secondly, we investigated the co-occurrence matrices to quantify the effects of blockiness, so those discontinuities in correlation due to the blockiness effects. So you can see here the three overlaid co-occurrence matrices for each color plane, red, G, and blue. For D equal 1 and horizontal direction, so differences between the current pixel and the right neighbor. Again, you can see a larger spread for the degraded image. And because the fractal dimension can be also estimated based on the Fourier spectra, we investigated also the Fourier spectra of the two images. But since there is no method for estimating the fractal dimension starting from 2D Fourier spectra, still you can observe that there are the content, the frequency content of the degraded images is much more larger than for the original one. So you can see there is an increase, there is an addition of higher frequencies in the signal, which again corresponds to the blockiness effect and any other discontinuities in your signal. But these two 2D spectra do not allow us to estimate the fractal dimension. But we can, if you look at V equals zero, which is the spatial frequency V, and you look only at the other spatial frequency U, you can see the fractal dimension for the corresponding 1D signal. It is again larger for the degraded image. So we said it's okay. We have a method for assessing the degradation. This is the experimental setup we used. An MPEG-4 video streaming server and a network emulator to emulate different situations, different packet loss percentages and delays and so on. And the client, which was modified to save each video frame in a bitmap file. And we test for three standard video sequences. And these are some details about the video signal we used. And here are some more results for if the first results were for the case when the degraded image is affected by severe degradation, so you cannot accept the quality of that degraded image. Here's a case when the degradation is, let's say, acceptable. You can see the delta in the color fractal dimension, it is smaller, and there is the difference between the lacunarity curve curves is a little bit smaller. We also encountered in our test some cases when the degraded video frame looks like this, like almost green, completely green frame. In that case, the color fractal dimension of the degraded signal it is smaller than for the original one, and of course, maybe you don't expect this in terms of degradation, but in terms of fractal complexity, this is in accordance to the model, because this image is not as complex as the original one. And because this is a more uniform image at every scale, the lacunarity curve for the degraded one is above the lacunarity curve of the original one. And if we are to take the full reference scenario, you can see here the blue curve representing the color fractal dimension versus time for the female video sequence, and in red the color fractal dimension as a function of time for the degraded sequence. So you can see the increase or the delta in the color fractal dimension, indicating the time intervals when the video signal was degraded. But there is an issue even for any other metric. If there are the information from the receiver from the transmitter is completely lost, then you have to realign your signals. As for the lacunarity curves as a function of time, in the top image you can see the lacunarity curves as a function of time for the football original test sequence, and the lacunarity curve. Curves as a function of time for the degraded video sequence. And you can see that for severe degradation, the lacunarity curves in this region are above even the maximum lacunarity of the original signal. This means that to detect the severe degradation in your video signal, you may use the lacunarity even in a no reference scenario. In conclusions, we say it's okay to use the color fractal dimension and lacunarity as a reduced reference scenario, but a real-time implementation for the computation of the two metrics is required. As I said, lacunarity can be used even as a no reference metric to detect severe degradation. And some conclusions about the approach itself. The extension from cubes to hypercubes was natural and intuitive, and it was in accordance with the cubical organization of the RGB space, even if the RGB color space is not a Euclidean color space. However, we used the Minkowski infinitive norm when counting how many pixels fall inside the hyperboxes. And from the human vision point of view, maybe RGB is not the best color space, so we envisage to develop the method in LAB or some other color space. And just for further work, so if you wait for the next paper, you will see a comparison with the existing video quality metrics, and some results of our subjective tests with video frames from the test sequences and with synthetic color fractal images we generated. Thank you very much. I have to say that today I also represent the signals and images and communications laboratory in Poitiers, France. So thank you for your attention.
We have 2 minutes for questions. Okay. I have a question for you. What type of degradation you can evaluate here? Because what I have noticed is that very likely you are targeting video communication or streaming. For instance, if you have blur in the video sequence, can you estimate that or that?
Yes. So if it's only blur, then this means that the degraded image will have smaller frequencies or lower frequencies. Then I should expect a lower complexity of those images. So the delta in the color fractal dimension should be negative. But if we are talking only about blur, but if in our case the degradation was blockiness, new colors, so it was more than just blur.
Yeah, but if you have like combination of blur and then also blockiness, and
we have to try this. I don't have an answer right now.
Okay. Thank you again.
Thank you.